Let's be honest, have we ever so misunderstood what our cats want as much as when it comes to when, where, and how they prefer to drink water? Look at it this way. Go to Amazon and search for a dog water dish. You pretty much get 1,000 versions of a bowl. Now search for a cat water dish, and what do you see? Actually, I've already done it for you, and here's a snapshot of the results. There's a wide range of confusing options. A metal bowl or ceramic? What shape, material, or color? Maybe some fun painted cat picture or some funny markings on it? Or what about a fancy fountain? Do cats really need those? Welcome to Pet Spotlight, where today we're diving into the science of cats and good old H2O. There's so much more than meets the eye when cats' evolutionary history collides with modern domestic house life. Part of the reason this topic is so confusing is that cats are pretty weird when it comes to water. Why are they obsessed with running faucets but hate swimming or bathing? Why are they so picky about what kind of bowl they use? And can I really change their drinking habits simply by giving them the right kind of dish? Here's a hint, the answer might not be what you've heard. To understand the modern house cat, we first need to go back in time and recall their origins. Felis catus, the domestic cat, is actually a descendant of wild cat species that emerged in the desert climates of the Middle East over 100,000 years ago. Modern house cats emerged about 10,000 years ago. Survival in these dry landscapes also centered around one critical resource above all others, water. This evolutionary pressure shaped wild cats into adept hunters and also gave them unique adaptations to find sparse water sources. For example, did you know that cats can actually smell out water? And did you know that water content from food can be a significant source of hydration for cats? This important desert cat history helps explain some of the particular drinking habits of our feline companions today. So what exactly is it that cats are looking for in their modern cushy house life? A lot of their picky preferences come directly from their evolutionary past. For example, cats have an innate tendency to keep their key resources separated. They like their food, their water, and their toilet areas to be in different zones. This explains why some cats might refuse to drink or eat if their bowls are too close together. So they might be cute, but it could help to stay away from hyper-efficient double bowl setups that you see at the pet store. Cats also inherently dislike stagnant water sources. Still water can accumulate bacteria, fungi, or parasites over time, so pools of stagnant water are breeding grounds for pests and disease. This would explain the obsession so many cats have with running water coming from taps and fountains. If your cat can't stay away from the sink or bathtub you're using, now you know why. The flow and motion signals freshness, and it likely mimics the rivers and streams that big cats accessed in nature. So while running water bowls and fountains might seem like spoiling our cats domestically, they actually cater perfectly to felines' past history. Now, of course, hydration is super important for cats. Poor water intake can lead to all kinds of kidney problems, bladder stones, and other health issues. So when it comes down to it, how can we best set our cats up for success? We've got a few concrete tips. First, thanks for joining us on Pet Spotlight. If you're enjoying this video, please help us spread the word by hitting that like button and subscribing to the channel. First off is a tip that doesn't sound like it's related to water. Watch what you feed your cat. Pay attention to the water content and make sure you're supplementing their diet as needed to meet their needs. Cats who eat canned cat food might get a lot more of their water from that as opposed to cats eating only dry food. Then, when it comes to drinking options, avoid bowls with close sides. I'm sure you've noticed cats have prominent whiskers that provide essential sensory information about their environment. Bowls with high, narrow sides can cause unpleasant friction of their whiskers on the side of the bowl when cats are trying to drink. Wide, shallow dishes are a lot less irritating for them. Also, while stainless steel bowls seem sleek, the shiny surface can create confusing reflections for cats who are trying to gauge water level and location. Even solid colored bowls can have a similar effect, with cats struggling to identify the water surface due to their poor depth perception. I often saw my cat doing this weird thing where it looked like she was poking the surface of the water with her nose. It turns out she just couldn't see where the water surface was until it hit her right in the face. So if we put all these pieces together, the best setup for a cat is probably a fountain or a running water dish which creates movement and sound that identifies freshness. You might have seen claims that running water helps cats drink more, but it turns out multiple scientific studies that measured water intake and urine output found no meaningful increase in hydration in cats with running water compared to still water dishes. But the running water is still helpful for the other reasons we've discussed. So if you can, aim for a fountain with a pool that's wide enough to avoid bothering cats' whiskers and also has some kind of pattern or marking on the bottom to help with their depth perception. Just be sure to regularly clean fountain parts and replace water filters because even moving water can get gross over time. You should head on over to this video next, which explains the scientific reasons behind some of cats' most curious behaviors, including why they purr and why they might bring you dead animals as quote-unquote gifts. Thanks for joining us, and as always, we would be grateful if you hit that like button and subscribed to Pet Spotlight to stay up to date on the latest pet-related science. Until next time!